Since he took over as executive director and when he hired me to lead the school, that it's important. important that this body have a voice in the school. And I agree with them. And it's been some years to get to this point, but we are here. And these individuals you see before us are going to lead. They're already leading. That's why they're here. I can look through all of them, and each and every one of them has grown in some way, shape, or form. But they walk the walk. They come to school every day. They're never disrespectful. They are all beautiful spirits and kind hearts, and they're leaders in their own right. They each lead in their different ways, and so they are beautiful people. So yes, give them a round of applause. Athletes, poets, artists. Yeah, Corey, poets. He always does that when I say that. Artists, athletes, scholars. Future doctors, lawyers. We have one of us before us, Ms. Anaya Allen. I'm sending her. She sent a recommendation letter and submitted an application to go to Princeton for a couple. And I told Mom, I think it's about $3,000 it's going to cost us, but you have to invest in that.
Amen.
You have to invest in that, and that's money well spent. So we're waiting. You should see her recommendation letter. So hopefully in the next couple of years we have more students have the opportunity to do something like that. But I could go on and on talking about some of the growth areas of these individuals. But like I stated, they are going to be instrumental in making sure the school stays open. We go through our school effectiveness review sometime between now and March. And part of that process is one of the focus groups are with, of course, myself and my leadership team, but parents and then students. And they're going to sit and talk to students. And they talk to the students more than they talk to us. They ask questions that they don't even ask of us. And so it's this body and how they respond that's going to play a key role in the next 3 to 5 years for Connections and whether or not Connections stays open. And as the leader of the school, I could not be more confident and more humble to have these individuals represent me in front of whoever comes to talk about us. And so, parents, this is a testament to you all, loved ones, grandparents, godparents, aunties, uncles. This is a testament to you all, and you all deserve a round of applause today for yourselves. So do that. Again, I could talk forever, and I'm not today because I want to get to it. It's been a long day. This is my students, my babies. If nobody told you they loved you today, you know I love you and I'm proud of you. Thank you all. So at this time, I'm going to bring up my boss, my partner in this work, my thought partner, my battle buddy. We fight, we argue, but I wouldn't want to work for anybody else. He leaves, I go. And so that's what it's been. And so at this time, I want to bring up my boss, the executive director of Baltimore Teaching Network, Mr. Elijah Evans.
Good evening.
Good evening.
It is indeed a pleasure to be here. I'm excited to be here. I'm excited for this night. And let me just tell for our parents and our guests, you know, we make a big deal about SGA. Student Government Association. And one of the reasons why we make such a big deal about it is because it is one of the building blocks, one of the foundational blocks for our great leaders in history, in society. You know, men like Barack Obama was involved in student government. Bill Clinton was involved in student government. You know, Thurgood Marshall was involved in student government. Those were the building blocks for, they didn't know what they were going to become in the future, but they had a strong foundation to build on. And so we make a big deal. We wish we can make a bigger deal out of students going through this process. I want to say to the students, you've been selected and you've been elected by 500 other students. So out of everybody in the school, they looked at you and they said, you should represent me. They said, you can speak for me. So now that you have been elected, you have an awesome responsibility to step into that role with a heavy sense of responsibility. People are depending on you. they're depending on you to speak for them when they can't speak for themselves. They're depending on you to represent their wants, their desires, their aspirations, not so much yours. When you sit in that room with Mr. Brooks and with the other administrators advocating for what the students want, it's not for you to advocate for what you want. The students want chocolate ice cream, but you like vanilla ice cream. It ain't your job to advocate for vanilla ice cream. It's your job to advocate for the chocolate ice cream, because that's what the students want. Okay? That's one of the problems that we have in society today, that our elected officials forget who voted for them, who sent them to Washington. That's why in a few short months we'll get an opportunity to correct some of that. You know, if they don't represent the people need to speak up and put in place who they need to represent them. So you have an awesome responsibility. Those of you who have been appointed or selected as aides to the president, big job, because you are the president's ears. You're the president's eyes. You represent the president of student government. And so you should act like you represent the president of student government. And it's not for you to do what the president would do. It's for you to go back and inform the president so that the president can make the proper decision. And for the president and vice president, yours is an awesome task, because you have to stand before the student body and say that I hear you, I feel you, I represent you, and I will speak truth to power, and I will represent you when I meet with the administration. Yours is not the job of doing what the administration wants you to do. Yours is the job to do what the student body wants you to do. It's a difference. Okay, it's a difference. We believe in student voice, just like we believe in teacher voice. Everybody should have a voice. That's why this is a true democracy. Okay? So, when you have chicken smell in the air, it's wise to be short on your remarks, so I'm not going to be long today. But I am happy, I'm glad that we have come out tonight to support our young people. You know, it's a funny thing the way society works. You know, there are events like this going on in different areas of our city, but you don't see it on the news. There ain't no TV cameras here, you know. But if somebody was getting shot, there'd be TV cameras here. You know, somebody was getting murdered, somebody was getting robbed, there'd be TV cameras here. But these leaders right here of our future, ain't no TV cameras here, but we're here, and we can see, and we can report on what they're doing. And so, I've been given this piece of paper. Am I supposed to read this? Mm-hmm. No, okay. I will read. I'm glad I got my glasses this time. Okay. It says, President, the president is usually responsible for setting the SGA meeting agenda, facilitating meetings, appointing additional officers, being as SGA spokesman or spokesperson, or delegating another officer to do so, and working with the rest of the executive board to set the strategic direction of the SGA. When a task arises that falls outside of the other officer's responsibilities, it's the president's responsibility to ensure that the task is delegated and completed. So the president has a big responsibility. The vice president is to back up the president, to act when the president is not available, to act when the president is unable to act. The vice president fills the position's role whenever they are unable to do so and supports the president in any way needed. Often the vice president will take on responsibility for listening with outside, for liaise with outside organizations, such as other student governments, parent groups, etc., and attending meetings on behalf of the president. But the vice president's responsibility can also be very flexible to meet the needs of the SGA. The president, what's not mentioned here, though, is the president has a seat on the board of directors of Baltimore Teacher Network. So that is the board that governs the entire organization. And those meetings are usually held in this room every fourth Tuesday of the month at 5 o'clock. And it's open to the public. Anybody can attend those meetings. Presidential aid, this is saying a lot of what I've already said. Presidential aid assists the president and the vice president in various tasks and responsibilities to ensure the smooth functioning of the student government. Presidential aid serve as an advisor to the president and vice president, offering input and advice on various matters, helping the president and vice president make informed decisions, and representing the presidential cabinet at meetings, functions, and other events. That's what the presidential aides do. Secretary. The secretary is responsible for taking meeting minutes during meetings and making sure that the minutes and other documents and communications are clear and organized. Your secretary may also take on responsibility for communicating with stakeholders and organizations within or outside of the school. The treasurer. I just want people to know who you are, because if there's any money missing, they know who they see. The treasurer is responsible for managing any money collected or administered by the SGA. This could include working with the SGA members to budget for planned events, setting fundraising goals, meeting with the school administrators to budget student activity funds for SGA's projects, or collecting, counting, and delivering money from fundraisers to the proper school administrator. There's only one person in the school, Mr. Cox now? Dave Cox? Only one person in the school that actually should be handling money at Connections, and that's Mr. David Cox. Sometimes he will delegate Ms. Kim Johnson to do that, but you will be working closely with them, okay? So that's what the treasurer does. Mental health advisor, that's a new position, mental health advisor. That's good. I need some of that right here as well. The mental health ambassador is responsible for advocating for and building a culture of awareness, distinguishing mental health, destigmatizing mental health and connecting peers and appropriate resources. The mental health ambassador may collaborate with other clubs and organizations to promote school-wide wellness initiatives. Representatives. The representatives are like the Congress. SGA representatives are individuals who support the efforts of all events and activities by the SGA. Representatives may help with poster setup, cleanup of events, or engage with the student body. Representatives act as a model citizens in the school community and promote the events and the efforts of the Student Government Association. So those are your responsibilities. So, needless to say that if you are a part of the student government, you are a representative of the student body, you should always be and should know that people are always going to have their eyes on you, you know. And it's not that you can't have a bad day, because we all have a bad day sometimes, but your bad day cannot be seen by others. I'll say that again. Your bad day can't be seen by others. When they look at you, they always got to look at excellence. You know, they always got to see, you got to be a role model all the time, 24/7. Whenever you step in the spotlight, take a position. So I don't care what you used to do yesterday. I don't care what your behaviors used to be yesterday. But from this day forward, once you take this oath of office, once you raise your hand and swear to take this oath of office, from this day forward, you have to take on a different characteristic. people are going to expect a lot from you, okay? So, with that said, I appreciate you all for coming out. I wish more of us would have been here, but this room was filled right now. But everybody should have somebody come out and support their kids. That's important. That's important. But we're here, and if nobody came out for you, know that we're here for you. We are your family. Connections is your family. BTN is your family. We love you. We look forward to working closely with you. They just came back. Some of them went to Annapolis to speak with their legislators just yesterday. But we also have future trips planned for them. We are going to Detroit later this month. We will be going to Washington, D.C. Our Congressman Kwasi Mfume will be planning a trip to the White House. I hope it's done before the election. But ain't no telling who might be in the White House. But we'll be going to the White House, and we're going to go visit Congress in Washington, D.C. Those are future things that they're going to be doing. So thank you all very much, and we look forward to working with the student government. So please give them another round of applause.
Substitute teaching at the school last year, and it's great to see all of you in the growth over a year period. I can actually see it in many of you, and you know, I'll just really quickly, because I'm not going to be the one standing between you and chicken, but I want to echo some of what Mr. Etheridge said. You guys, whether you like it or not, you're role models. I ran for mayor in 2020. And don't take those privileges for granted. The opportunities that you often look around, unfortunately, right here in Baltimore, our own government, we've seen people take advantage of the privilege to represent the people, and it got them in more trouble. If that's something you can't handle, you need to let someone else do it. But I know that all of you can handle it. I know many of you were in this position last year, and it's a great step towards further leadership. All of you, without a doubt. And it's a wonderful thing when I was given the privilege to be here tonight, I did everything I could to clear my evening schedule because this is important. As it was talked about with Mr. Brooks, where it's so much said about Baltimore City school students, but we know that that's not the representation of all of them. It's only some. And we don't talk as much about this. And I will talk about y'all on the radio, so at least one media outlet is here. And I've already told Mr. Brooks, we went through something last year with the Baltimore Collegiate School for Boys, another charter school that was going through some stuff. Politicians, it's all politics, stuff y'all need to worry about right now, this level of politics. What you need to worry about is making sure the school is excelling and telling the story of the school. They need to see the dancing and the drumming and all of the opportunities that are presented at an art school, all of the exposure that you all are getting. And trust me and believe that, you know, while being a teacher was not my calling, what takes a special person to be a teacher, having a voice where I am and being able to connect with politicians and connect with those decision makers, they hear us, they hear me, they hear my partners every single day. And there is no doubt in my mind that the pressure we put on the people who make the decisions to keep Baltimore Collegiate School open, to have money for what's called a boost program, to allow more kids opportunities at schools they wouldn't necessarily have, is because some of us who understand this made sure it wasn't forgotten. And y'all have that same word for me for connections as y'all go through this year, because I won't allow that to happen silently. So, with that being said, we're going to start with the oath of office. So, those of you who are SGA representatives, middle school and high school, if you want to rise, stand up. Middle school and high school, okay. All right, so we're going to go with the state your name. So when you repeat after me, you can state your name and we'll go down the list. So each of you will say your names individually, okay? And I think we got to raise our hand because we're swearing that we're going to arm this oath. Make it your right hand. All right? So this is for connections, middle school and high school, SGA representatives. I, state your name. And repeat after me. Hereby affirm that I will faithfully serve the students of connection. Act in accordance with the Student Government Association Constitution. I will fulfill all duties and responsibilities required of an SGA representative of the Student Government Association. I will, to the best of my ability, strive to achieve the high level of expectation that accompanies the office of the president of the Student Government Association. Congratulations to all of you. Middle school and high school SGA executive officers, rise. We're going to do the same thing, okay? All right. The president can wait. You get a special one. All right. Hereby affirm. That I will faithfully serve the students of the Connections Act, act in accordance with the Student Government Association Constitution. I will fulfill all duties and responsibilities required of an SGA executive officer of the Student Government Association. I will, to the best of my ability, strive to achieve the high level of expectation that accompanies the office of the president.
That I come to be the office of the president.
Of the Student Government Association.
Of the Student Government Association.
Congratulations. And Madam President. Hereby affirm that I will faithfully serve the students of Connections, act in accordance with the Student Government Association Constitution. Association Constitution, yeah, that's a big one. Now, I will fulfill all duties and responsibilities required of the president of the Student Government Association.
I will, to the best of my ability,
strive to achieve the high level of expectation
that accompanies the office
of the president of the Student Government Association. Congratulations to you. Congratulations to all of you once again. You have a tall task in front of you. You all have some fights that other schools and student government associations don't have, because when you're doing well and you're thinking outside the box, people look at you all differently. But y'all are going to do a fantastic job. So with that, for the first time, let me introduce our president, President Morsley.
Shout out Leah's mom.
family. I used to teach at Robert Coleman many, many years ago, and that's where I first met her. She was active there. She's been active through this whole process, and that's kind of a testament to show that parents being active kind of promotes kids to do other and bigger things. So thank you to all the parents who continue to be active. I know with schedules and different commitments that it's difficult, but shout out to you, Mom.
Thank you.
And I believe Dr. Howe. Oh, that's right. Okay, so I guess let there be food.
Congratulations, you all.
Dinner coming up very soon, where we are looking forward to having some parents involved in this process, where they'll be presenting a big project out to our community members. So please, please look out for some information about that next step when it comes to our SGA this school year. Again, thank you all for being here. I'm not sure how the food order is going to happen. Dr. Howe stepped out, so are we ready?
So Mr. Jacobs, are we ready?
Yes, please.
We're good? Okay, so at this time, yes, thank you.